Roll call, please.
Mrs. Schupe?
Here.
Mr. Fitzgerald?
Here.
Mrs. Donato?
Here.
Mrs. Jenkins?
Here.
Mr. Augustine?
Here.
Mr. Fodor?
Present.
Mr. Hack?
Here. Need an agenda approval?
I'd like to make a motion to amend the agenda to add under new business the approval for Grant Street repair.
I have a motion.
I'll second it.
That was a little.
I'll second it.
Mr. Fitzgerald?
Yes.
Mrs. Donato?
Yes.
Mrs. Jenkins?
Yes.
Mr. Augustine?
Yes.
Mr. Fodor?
Yes.
Mrs. Schupe?
Yes.
Mr. Hack?
Yes. Thank you. Okay.
Make a motion to approve the agenda.
Second.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Mrs. Donato?
Yes.
Mrs. Jenkins?
Yes.
Mr. Augustine?
Yes.
Mr. Fodor?
Yes.
Mrs. Schupe?
Yes.
Mr. Fitzgerald?
Yes.
Mr. Hack?
Yes. Thank you. Invocation tonight will be given by Mr. Augustine. All right, please stand.
Holy One, you have given us the responsibility of leadership in the affairs of our city. May what we say and do here this night be worthy of your sight and for the benefit of those who have entrusted us with this duty. Amen.
Amen. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Is there a public comment from our visitors? We will now recognize visitors. Please raise your hand if you wish to speak. When called upon, please use podium, clearly state your name and address into the microphone, and limit your comments to 3 minutes. Any dialogue must be conducted through me as president of council. Although your comments or questions be addressed to the council, the administration, or both. Sorry, anyone else?
Sir, point of order. We need to approve minutes from our work session regular meeting.
I'm sorry. We have a work session from 9/16/19 and a regular meeting at 9/16/19.
Move to approve.
Second.
We have roll call, please.
Mrs. Jenkins?
Yes.
Mr. Augustine?
Abstain.
Mr. Fodor?
Yes.
Mrs. Schupe?
Yes.
Mr. Fitzgerald?
I think I have to abstain.
Mrs. Donato?
Yes.
Mr. Hack?
Yes. Public comments from visitors.
Hello, my name is Arnie Rodriguez. I own several properties here in Painesville, in particular 144 Nebraska Street. The bill goes to my uncle and I are partners in this this housing. The bills go to my uncle. He lives on Washington Street, and he gives me the bills, and I take them to the tenant. The tenant pays them. Okay, if the property is empty, I pay the bills. Okay. My tenant has to pay the bill. When he got there, they added $135.47 onto his bill. He said, where did this come from? And they said, they transferred from another account. So when I called utilities this past Monday, they told me the same thing. They transferred from another account. And the lady I talked to gave me a different account number that's one of this account from Nebraska. Okay? If the property is vacant, I pay the bills. I know because I'm the one with the checker. Okay? We have never received any past due amounts for this location. Okay. If I give it to the tenant and the tenant doesn't pay it, I eventually will take it out of the security deposit and pay it. So when I called us and said, where is this amount coming from? This lady tells me September of 2012, 7 years ago, you're adding $135.47 in 2012? What kind of record keeping is this? I mean, I got to reimburse this guy. So I need to be reimbursed or get a credit for this. Where's 2012 coming from? And then I get another name, Godinez. He might have been the previous tenant. So if he's the previous tenant, I think I know where he lives. And if he does owe money, you go after the person that's in their name. But this isn't my uncle's name, and which is me and I'm his partner. So where is this coming from 7 years ago? And then Tracy, collection analyst, I've left her two messages. I still haven't received anything. So if we really owe this, I need to see proof.
The best thing you can do is reach out to me, and I can handle this.
Okay.
The council doesn't have to handle it. I can handle it for you.
Okay.
So if you call the city manager's office and we can talk it through.
Okay. Talk to you?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Any reports, PCA?
Good evening. The Board of Zoning Appeals held their regularly scheduled meeting on Thursday, September 19, 2019. One variance request was heard at the meeting. The board approved a request to allow a 10-foot variance into a 25-foot required rear yard setback for the construction of a covered roof over an existing rear patio at 1542 Elderberry Lane. No other matters came before the board.
Questions or comments? Thank you. Economic development?
Yes, so we had a discussion about the CRA area number 5. The school board did approve that. The administration has begun working with the Montrose Group to evaluate our current legislation as well as the school board approvals to ensure that we're in accordance with new regulations through the state of Ohio and the ORC regarding CRAs. We talked about the Richmond Corridor study. Richmond Street City and Corridor Enhancement Plan is now completed and administration is doing a final review of the plan. After that, the administration is going to begin working through the action items within the plan. The first part that they're going to be working on will be the standards, the design standards for the corridor. Kathy Biederman, our Economic Development Director, has several community standards and she's going to use those as a guide in setting the standards for Richmond Street, as well as creating guidelines for other city entryways. And then the only other thing is the council will recall that last year we reinstituted the John I. Claire Award. Those nominations will be taken this winter. And the notice for nominations will be in the next citywide newsletter. So keep an eye out for that. And if you have anybody that you would like to recommend, please do so at that time.
Thank you. Any questions for Katie or DGO?
The Downtown Painful Organization Board of Directors met on the 25th of September. We had committee updates from each committee. The board as a whole discussed that we need to raise members in the committees and participation in the committee. So anyone wishing to get more involved with the Downtown Painful Organization can reach out to me or any other board member. We also elected a new vice president, Jan Andel of United Methodist Church. So she'll be our new vice president. The board prepared for 2020 year by discussing board membership, slate of officers, budget and sponsorships, and work plans, and preparing to get those ready for the next year. Our Downtown Painesville organization executive director is leaving the DPO at the end of the calendar year. David has made the Downtown Painesville a better place in the last 5 years. We value his relationship with the community and wish him luck as he moves on. He's currently assisting us with a transition committee, which consists of active board members who will get all of David's responsibilities as well as meet with all the sponsors and make sure that the sponsors know David's going out and as well as coming in with the new board director, or executive director. There's also a search committee. The search committee will handle the hiring process of the new board executive director. The search committee gave approved timelines for events and the job was posted on indeed.com. Interviews will start at the end of October.
Any questions? Comments? Thank you. We'll move into legislation right now. If you wish to comment on this legislation, unless we want to do so at this time, those make such a request will then be called upon after the reading. Any dialogue must be conducted through me as president of the council. Although your comments or questions can be addressed to the council, the administration of all. When called upon, please use the voting. Remember, clearly state your name and address into the microphone and limit your comments to 3 minutes. So we have ordinance number 1, third reading. And ordinance number 2, third reading. Okay, ordinance number 1, third reading.
An ordinance enacting section 933.191 of the Painesville Code of 1998 related to water system infrastructure improvement fee and declaring an emergency.
Which is good, outstanding.
All right, thank you.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Mrs. Jenkins?
Yes.
Mr. Augustine?
Yes.
Mr. Fodor?
Yes.
Mrs. Schupe?
Yes.
Mr. Fitzgerald?
Yes.
Mrs. Donato?
Yes.
Mr. Hack?
Yes. Ordinance number one passed. Ordinance number two, third reading.
An ordinance amending section 933.19 of the Code of Ordinances relating to water rates and declaring an emergency.
Once again, if you have any questions,
Katie, any questions?
Move to adopt.
Second. Mr. Augustine?
Yes.
Mr. Fodor?
Yes.
Mrs. Schupe?
Yes.
Mr. Fitzgerald?
Yes.
Mrs. Donato?
Yes.
Mrs. Jenkins?
Yes.
Mr. Hack?
Yes. Ordinance number two passed.
Thank you so much.
All right, we have unfinished business, oversized vehicles. Oversized vehicles.
I guess what I would like is, you know, when we first brought this on board, Valerie had sent everybody information on what the other minutes had said for other meetings. So Paul and I were thinking that we'd like to have everybody look at them over the next 2 weeks, and then we'll either talk about it at our next council meeting, or we'll remove it at our next council meeting, so that we can, because I don't want to do it tonight, because it's moving now.
Why?
So we'll do it to you.
Well, is anybody prepared to speak with us tonight?
Is that me? Yeah.
Doesn't look like it.
Okay. Great. We'll move into the new business.
Brain Street thing?
Yes.
Your thing?
Yes, it is my thing. So Monica, can you... So there's an issue on Grant Street. It's a small... It's not a small section, but there's a section of concrete that... Now that Jackson Street's open, there's been issues with a few of the houses that are vibrating pretty bad from these kind of trucks that are running through there. Because they still get trucks that run to Blue Resolve. There's a manufacturing place on Jackson Street. And I spoke to Monica, and it looks like we have money available for the reason to approve it to repair a section of the concrete street. The street itself is in pretty good shape. Except for some reason, this section that's probably 40 by 20 foot that's just caved in, it's fell apart.
It's crumbled. Do we have to have legislation to amend the budget and all that stuff?
No, so when Paul brought this to me, Green Street is not on any of our road improvement plans. So I wasn't comfortable moving forward because it hadn't come to council to be talked about before. What I did do is go back. A couple of our projects came in under budget, so we do have a PO that's open that has the repairs are estimated around $21,000. And we do have that in an open PO, so there would not need to be a budget adjustment, but it is a road that we have not talked about as a council and administration, so I was not comfortable moving forward without council discussing it.
Are there any more pressing or previously discussed projects for that value that done?
For 21,000?
Okay, hold on, there's...
No, every other street project that's on there is 100 plus 1,000.
We need a vote.
I think we just need to tell her our feelings on this one, don't we?
No, I'd like a vote.
You want a vote?
Yes.
We have a vote, please. Do we have to make a motion?
Yes.
Motion to approve repairs to Grant Street as discussed.
Second.
Who seconded?
Jeremy, don't need any legislation, so we didn't go out for bid or anything like that?
We got quotes on it. It's not a budget adjustment because it's already within the budget. So there is no need for a budget adjustment or it's not a major rebuild project, so it's a professional service. So it doesn't have to go out to bid as long as we do proper quotes.
So I know you should be comfortable with that one ring. Why do we need to build that?
So this is one of those where if it was on the road plan, we probably would move forward without having a discussion because that road plan had previously been approved by council, but this has never been approved by council through any of our conversations.
a discretion of the city manager that she personally wants to vote on it.
Does motion still stand?
The motion still stands. Mr. Fodor?
Yes.
Mrs. Schut?
Yes.
Mr. Fitzgerald?
Yes.
Mrs. DiNello?
Yes.
Mrs. Jenkins?
Yes.
Mr. Augustine?
Yes.
Mr. Hack?
Yes, thank you. We have no department presentation. We have no administrative reports. Law director.
I would like to get this done.
Thank you, sir. Tina Ashburn.
I will be at a conference at the next council meeting, so you'll have Doug sitting in at the next council meeting. That's our report.
Correspondence for the council.
The next regular council meeting will be held Monday, October 21st at 7:30. The last farmer's market is this Thursday from noon to 4. The fall community cleanup day is Saturday, October 12th, which is this Saturday. Volunteer with the city to serve as a coordinator for your street, neighborhood, or area. Contact City Hall for more information. Fall Fest is October 19th at Rec Park.
Closing comments, Nick?
I just have a couple things for today. I just wanted to bring to everybody's attention, if they haven't seen the flyer already, but College Hall, Lake Erie College Hall, has gotten the opportunity to get a grant to preserve College Hall. So a big bell tower building on Lake Erie College campus. This has to do with women's rights to vote. So they could get a grant to, I think, give them up to $150,000 to improve the building. So you can vote up to 5 times a day, 5 every day. So I urge everybody to go out there. Pam Palermo from Lake Erie College has passed these things out all over the city. So if you look down, you can find one somewhere. Or I can give you mine. But the other thing I just got a call on was weekly leaf service. I think effective 10-1 to 12-15, they're picking up leaves every week on your scheduled garbage day. That's it.
Thank you. Jim?
Last Thursday, I attended the Aging in Lake County Conference, and the theme of this year's was integrating healthcare and community-based organizations. There was a wealth of information presented, as well as Denise was there from our senior organization. And currently trying to get a meeting together with Denise and Lori and Katie to have discussions about the seniors. So that's still in the works. That's all I got.
Thank you. Chrissy?
I got nothing.
Wow. Tom?
I'm good.
Katie?
I just put chocolate in my mouth.
Standard.
I thought I had more time.
Lori?
I just wanted to thank Monica for the third quarter report. Quite a lengthy document on that, I'll go through it, but I appreciate all the work that went into it. I did get to attend the first Fridays from the BPO last Friday, and also the Police Levy fundraiser, which was both events were very enjoyable experiences. Good to see and be out with the community and also get some shopping done. I also wanted to congratulate Jan from the VP, the former VP position of the Painville organization, and look forward to the work of the transition committee. I'm sure they'll do a great job. So I kind of look forward to that. That's all I have.
Thank you, Katie.
All right, sorry about that. Couple things. I wanted to remind everybody of this amazing gem that we have in our downtown called Joggin Hardware. I had the joy of working there when I was in high school, so I go back every so often to harass slash talk to Jeff. And I've been doing a new home improvement project, and I know had I gone anywhere else, they would have given me exactly what I came into looking for, and they would have sent me on my way. But in this particular situation, Jeff had a much better suggestion for me, and he was like, if that tool doesn't work, you just bring it back and I'll refund all your money. And it worked. And it's much better than the process than I would have done. So just encouraging people to go and check out Joggin Hardware. I know my old house when my glass fuses blew at 5:30 on a Friday. Joggin saved my butt that first time I opened my box and said, what the? So Joggin Hardware, please make sure you guys are going there. And then also community cleanup day this weekend. I will be helping slash overseeing a work party for Ward 2. And that location for meeting is going to be the old hospital site. But the big thing is the community cleanup's not just volunteer groups. It's also encouraging people to clean up around their house, around their property. So you don't necessarily have to join a group to be part of the community cleanup. Just, you know, go out, check your tree lawn, and do make a little bit of an impact while you can. And then lastly, I want to say farewell to Sip, our K-9. He has served us well over the years, and his service and time has been appreciated, and we appreciate everything that his handler has done during his time with us. That was it.
Thank you. Unfortunately, my son did not win the homecoming court. But he had a nice start there. But it was a really nice football game, and the weather was perfect. So it was just a great way to kind of end that time with the situation. So I'm very happy for Bishop, who did win, and it's part of my son. So at this point, I'm getting a motion to Jen from our record meeting.
Motion to adjourn from our regular meeting.
Second.
Mrs. Shue?
Yes.
Mr. Fitzgerald?
Yes.
Mrs. Sinella?
Yes.
Mrs. Dickens?
Yes.
Mr. Augustine?
Yes.
Mr. Boder?
Yes.
Mr. Hack?
Yes. I get a motion to adjourn.